You're welcome to our full moon sound bath. It is the full moon, the full flower moon. The Native Americans of North America like to name the moons, and this one is named full flower. Sometimes it's called the full corn planting moon, sometimes the full milk moon. But it is today. It is, we can take advantage of this energy of the full moon, which is allowing us to let go of things we no longer need. And in this global place where we find ourselves today, this world, we certainly could use some of that, couldn't we? Just to let go what we don't need anymore, what no longer serves us, so we can move forward to a place of taking meaningful action and doing the things that do move us forward to create our new world ourselves. So a couple of things, if anybody's new to sound bath, I'm certainly new to an online sound bath. This is the second time I'm doing it, so I'm getting a little bit better. I'm still on my little laptop, and I do have a monitor and a microphone and a separate camera coming next time. And I do have a microphone here, an external mic. So for any reason, anything gets wonky or, you know, just kind of pop something over here in the chat window and let me know if anything's weird. That would not be good if you couldn't hear a sound bath, because it is a sound bath. So, so I'm learning as we go. And I have to say, I do, one of the silver linings is to see people from all over that are not in my immediate community, and you would not otherwise be here at the sound bath except that it's online. So I'm really grateful for that, and I'm thankful that you're here. Ooh, and yes, Kristen, so good to see you. Hawaii, oh my, aloha, my friend. So many of you, so good to see you. Well, so headphones are helpful. If you have a set, it doesn't matter what kind they are. And if you don't, that's okay too. I think it might be a little clearer. Some folks have told me with headphones, and please, feedback is welcome, because these Facebook Live sound baths are new, and I would probably keep them going even once we start gathering. I would keep one going because I've been able to connect with people I would not otherwise be able to connect with, and I'm glad about that. So headphones, lying comfortably, sitting comfortably in a chair, eyes closed once we get started. You want to get yourself nice deep breaths in a state of allow and in a state of receiving. That's the state that I am in, and I invite you to be in as this energy through sound has no bounds of time or space, no bounds of distance, no bounds of time. You can hop on the web page tomorrow and you can get this. You can hop on the Facebook page and get this same recording and experience the healing benefits of sound healing. So we'll get started. Our theme this month is forgiveness. You know, understanding forgiveness, you know, it's like when forgiving really doesn't mean that we condone anything that might have happened to us. I think many of us know that. Or that the person who did something to harm us is blameless. That's not what we're saying, really. What we're saying is that it's just making a conscious choice to release ourselves from the burden or the pain and the stress of holding on to resentment. You know, when we've been hurt by someone, for instance, it's not always easy to let go. But you know, holding on to a grudge can really only make us feel worse, and not just emotionally. You know, resentment can cause our blood pressure to spike. It can trigger the release of stress chemicals that make us physically sick. And we certainly don't need that right now. We've got enough going on in the world, in this new world that we're waking up to, which I'm incredibly hopeful about. And like we talked about last month, it's and change is hard and can be challenging, so I honor both paths of getting to our best self. I thank you for coming tonight. You know, it's like they say, the not forgiving is like drinking poison and expecting that other person to suffer or get sick. So like any spiritual practice, and I know many of you have them, meditation included, you know, it's not so much that it's the practice that we do kind of when we're in the crisis or we're in the storm. It's the practice that we just do every day to prepare ourselves for that storm. So I'd like to start with a song. It's a forgiveness song. It was written by a woman that I had the pleasure of meeting. Her name was Lauren Lane Powell, and she was a member of the Threshold Choir. I belong to this Threshold organization. If you don't know anything about Threshold, I'd encourage you to look them up, thresholdchoir.org. But they're a wonderful group of people, and I think some of you on the call tonight may be members. So we sing, the motto of our organization is kindness made audible. We sing in a healing fashion. Song is medicine for anyone at the threshold. Oftentimes at bedside of those who are at the ultimate threshold, but it can be at any threshold. And we're at one right now, aren't we? As we step forward into a new world that we don't know what it looks like. We know what we don't want. We know so many pillars of society that have needed to change, but we don't really know what's happening going forward. So forgiveness, a wonderful practice. And Lauren passed away about a year ago or so, but she wrote many beautiful songs. She's a New Thought advocate and a well-known musician, but she wrote a song called Completely Forgiven, and we'll start with that, and that will be our theme tonight, and we'll start with it in song, so I invite you to get comfortable and just kick back. The words to her song are just beautiful. It's three parts. For anything that anyone has ever done to hurt me, knowingly or unknowingly, I forgive. The second part is, for anything I've ever done to anyone to hurt them, knowingly or unknowingly, I forgive. And the third piece to this just beautiful song of wisdom is about us, which is where it starts, which is what makes the biggest change, be the change we want to be in the world. For anything I've ever done at any time to hurt me, beautiful, knowingly or unknowingly, I forgive. And then she goes on to say, you are loved, you are whole, you're completely forgiven. For anything that anyone has ever done to hurt me, knowingly or unknowingly, I forgive. For anything I've ever done to anyone to hurt them, knowingly or unknowingly, I forgive. For anything I've ever done at any time to hurt me, knowingly or unknowingly, I forgive. You are loved, you are whole, you're completely forgiven. Given. So as we settle into whatever forgiveness practice we'd like to make it tonight, I invite you to relax and tune in to your heart. Just intend for your heart to open.
Thank you. Has ever done to hurt me, knowingly or unknowingly, I forgive. Knowingly or unknowingly, Let love wash over you. Let love wash over you. Let love wash over you. Gently. Let peace wash over you. Let peace wash over you. Let peace wash over you. Gently. Let peace fill you. Let peace fill you. Let peace fill you. Completely.
Thank you.
like to invite you to start coming back to your space. Wherever you are, still with your eyes closed, going anywhere. I'm just gonna finish up the bowls here. Let them do their work. Send you their medicine. And I'll keep the Facebook Live page going for a few more minutes while you just take your time. To your space and the time.